Hello, welcome to my mini training on the foundations to living longer and stronger after cancer treatment. My name is Dr. Megan Bernard. I'm a naturopathic doctor, and my life has been dedicated to learning the nuances of cancer support and what kind of nutrition and lifestyle changes and supplementation and IV therapies and treatments and things like that are in the alternative healthcare world that can help to complement your conventional treatment plan in order to give people their best results during treatment, but mostly to give people the best results after finishing treatment so that they can have more energy, so that they can feel like their health is back on track, and so that they can prevent cancer from ever coming back again. So in order to kind of gather this information and to be able to share it with people, I completed 3 degrees. I did a Bachelor of Health Science in Diagnostic Cytology, which is the detection and diagnosis of cancer at a cellular level. I also did a lot of research in my master's in pathology. It was awesome. I did research on breast cancer and the immune system using gingerol, which is an extract from ginger. So we determined how gingerol may have an impact on inflammation and breast cancer cells. And then I also went and did a doctorate in naturopathy. And that was when I became a naturopathic doctor. And in order to do that 4-year degree, I had to do a clinical rotation, and I got to choose my rotation in naturopathic oncology, which was so good. It's been my passion forever to help people through their cancer diagnosis. So that was just the icing on the cake. And now that I am here, and you're listening to me, I want to share this information with you in this little training I have put together for you today. So let's get started on, firstly, like what happens in the body during and after cancer treatment. And cancer treatments such as chemo, radiation, surgeries, medications, things like that, what they do is they actually cause inflammation. And we want this. So inflammation, it has a bad reputation basically, but in cancer care, whenever you're getting treatment, we want inflammation to happen, because inflammation is what's going to mount an immune response, and that immune response is going to go out searching for your cancerous cells so that they can target those and kill them off and to directly kill them as well. So inflammation is great during treatment because that's what actually kills the cancer cells. However, when treatment has finished, there's not really any off switch. There's nothing there to say, so we're finished treatment, now stop inflammation, because whenever inflammation goes on for too long, whenever it's too much, then that is actually bad for our bodies. So after treatment, we want inflammation to go away, because inflammation that goes on too long, it can also be called chronic, is a known cancer promoter. We know this for a fact, that inflammation causes cancer. Okay. So it is common knowledge. It is heavily researched. We know that inflammation is one of the big, probably the biggest cause of cancer. So whenever we finish cancer treatment, we want to make sure that we stop that inflammation in its tracks. Not only is inflammation a cause of cancer, but inflammation also sucks all the energy from people too, because whenever you're finished treatment, your body's now in recovery and healing mode. It's trying to repair any tissue damage. It's trying to build new cells, new tissues, that kind of stuff, because the chemo, radiation, surgery have all gone and caused damage to that. Again, par for the course, it happens, but we want to help that to recover afterwards. And in order to recover all that inflammation and stop that inflammation from getting worse, then you're going to suck a lot of energy from you, because all that energy is going into these inflammatory processes and recovering instead of actually giving you energy to go out and like play with your kids, succeed at work, be there for your partner, or just simple things like keeping your house clean. So that's why people, when they finish cancer treatment, they have a lot of fatigue. And it's also a great time to start working on preventing inflammation to prevent cancer from coming back. Okay. So the question here is, how do you repair and prevent inflammation after cancer treatment? And the way you do that is actually fairly simple to say, and that is by making good food and good lifestyle choices that encourage healing and decrease inflammation from coming back again, or decrease inflammation in general, okay? And what we do for our clients, and what I do for my clients, is we approach inflammation, we approach these nutrition and lifestyle changes using these 6 pillars of health that help to create an anti-cancer environment. So let's go through those 6 pillars right now. So the first pillar is nutrition. which makes sense, right? We got to get proper nutrition to help rebuild tissue, to help you get energy production going, to help decrease inflammation in the body. So there's a lot we can do with nutrition. I'm not going to go through right now because we would go on forever and it's my favorite topic, but we're going to touch that probably in future trainings here, okay? We also address stress management. So that's pillar number two, stress management. We want to make sure that you are not as stressed, that cancer is not a constant fear for you, that you're not afraid of what foods to eat, what choices to make in your life. Okay, so we address stress as one of the pillars. Another pillar is sleep. If you're not sleeping well, sleep is a very important time to repair. So we got to make sure that you're sleeping well in order to repair well. Movement. So movement, exercise, that kind of stuff has been shown to prevent cancer. And a big reason for this is because we enhance the growth and the production of nice tissues. We make good tissues in the body and it decreases inflammation as well. We also need to talk about digestion and detoxification. So that's just one, that's pillar number five, digestion detoxification. You have to have good bowel movements. You have to break down your food really well. You have to absorb it really well. And we have to make sure that you're eliminating things, detoxifying things that we don't need in your body. And then the sixth pillar here is mindset. So we want to make sure that you have a good, happy mindset. We want you to feel joy. We want you to feel freedom and comfort whenever you make these nutrition and lifestyle changes. So just to recap again, one, nutrition, two, stress management, three, sleep, four is movement, five, digestion detoxification, and six is mindset, okay? So each of these, when not properly managed, can lead to cancer-promoting inflammation and energy-sucking inflammation in the body. So that's why these pillars are really kind of close to my heart when it comes to addressing these. And these are things that have popped up day after day, research paper after research paper, to be very important and integral to making sure that people live an anti-cancer lifestyle. The way that we work with people to address these pillars of health is through three foundational stages. And what these stages are is, one, we want to investigate and build your foundation of health. Two, we want to enhance your outcomes. And three, we want to maintain the results, okay? So let's just briefly go through these stage by stage. So stage one, investigating and building the foundation. So investigating is really key here. We want to know what's going on with you. We want to do a thorough investigation. We do a very thorough intake form. We want to know your health head to toe, your health head to toe, because these strategies have to be personalized. What worked for Sally down the street is not going to work for you. Whether you had the same cancer, same treatment, doesn't matter. Your life is completely different. What's going to work for you is completely different. Maybe Sally's totally fine with eating kale every day. Maybe you really hate kale. All right. So those things like that are not going to work for you. We got to figure out what you want, what you need, what your body wants, what your body needs. Your experience of your life was different than Sally down the street. So we got to investigate you. So that includes a very thorough intake form. You should do proper blood work. We review blood work and any specialty testing that pops up based on the symptoms that are coming on in your intake form. All right. We also need to know what cancer you had, what treatment you had, and just this information when all put together can determine your best route of action. So this is just telling us, what is your body telling you? So what is going on with your health so that we can then formulate a plan that's more specific to you and really kind of just what's holding you back from creating a rock solid anti-cancer environment in your body. So that's what a very thorough investigation and setting the foundations of your health looks like in stage one. Stage two is enhancing those outcomes. So this is where we give where you need the accountability, where you need the direction, where you need the evidence-based knowledge to follow. And this is where you kind of get like a mini medical degree. So this is like the meat and potatoes. This is where you really dig in and learn all about your body, all about your health, everything that's contributing to an anti-cancer environment in your body and decreasing inflammation. The thing here is it's got to be simple. It's got to be focused or you're not going to do it. That's just human nature and that's totally fine. So keep it simple, keep it focused, keep it in a good strategy, keep it organized. And this really makes a big difference on moving people forward instead of just kind of grasping information here, there, and everywhere and trying to fit that into someone's life. That is super overwhelming. It is super hard to follow. So the key is to keep things simple and focused so that people actually follow the instructions and learn and make changes, okay? So stage three is about maintaining the results. So we want to make sure that this lasts forever, because if you just do stuff with us because you're with us for a couple of weeks, couple of months, and then you go back to your old habits, that's going to make no difference in the long run when it comes to preventing cancer, because cancer doesn't just get prevented in a week or a day. It gets prevented throughout your entire life. So we need to make sure that you are learning lifelong habits, that you're going to be able to continue forward forever and not just for a couple of weeks or a couple of days. Okay, that makes no difference if you do that. It might make you feel better in the short term, but in the long run is what I'm really looking for here. I want you to prevent cancer forever. So how this works is we want you to do a gradual integration of changes in order to fit your lifestyle. So it's very step-by-step, it's very organized, it's very clear. You take the information you learned in like your mini medical degree in stage two, and now we put it in to action tasks. So day by day, week by week, you make small changes that suit your lifestyle, that work with your day-to-day, so that you actually make these changes. All right, so that's the important part. People take information left, right, and center, but do they actually put it into action? Not too often, okay? So this is how you truly develop lifelong habits that will help you prevent cancer for the long run and help you to be energetic for the long run. So to review, whenever you address your health in an organized and thorough fashion and in a way that's very personalized to you, this is what is really going to get you better energy. This is going to give you better overall health and help you to keep cancer from coming back in the long run. There's so much research out there showing that nutrition and lifestyle changes really and truly do make a difference in preventing cancer and getting cancer in the first place. So you have power here. You have the ability to make a change in your future. You just gotta put them in the right steps. You got to make the right moves forward and you gotta use the evidence. You can't just be grasping information from left, right, and center, hoping that it'll work for you because it worked for Sally down the street. So to do that, you wanna investigate. You wanna build your foundation. You want to have a very personalized and organized plan for you. You want to enhance these outcomes to make sure that you're staying on track forever, that you're really, truly understanding what's going on in your body and how that's coming out in your health. And you really want to maintain these results for the long run, because like I said, if you want to prevent cancer for your entire life, you got to do these changes for your entire life. Okay. So this is what each and every one of my clients experiences. This is what they go through. This is the reason why they are super successful in regaining their energy after health and health after treatment, and why they are feeling super confident that what they are doing is honestly in their best chances, is giving them the best chances of keeping cancer back for the long run. And I'm looking forward to potentially helping you work on that for yourself too.